Praise the Lord. God bless you. Welcome this morning to our morning worship service from the Apostolic Faith Church. We're located at 1325 Branch Avenue, Southeast Washington, D.C. This is our first live broadcast this morning, so we do cover your prayers as we worship together in the beauty of holiness. The word of God say, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Amen? So we give him praise and we give him thanks this morning for the privilege and opportunity that we have to worship him via internet. We are continuing to look to the hills from which all our help. Our help cometh from the Lord. We are joining me this morning is our assistant pastor, Brother Ayo Mobilurin, and also two of our media team members. My name is Reverend Josephine McElvin, and I'm privileged to serve as pastor here of the D.C. Church. So let us worship him this morning. We are just four of us here in the sanctuary, but we have an unseen host here. The angels of the Lord are in our midst, and we have an unseen host there or by the internet. Amen? So as you're in your home or wherever you may be, watching this by YouTube or listening by audio, let's give God praise. Let's worship him on this beautiful Sunday morning, because truly he is worthy. Right now, Brother Ayo will come and he will lead us in songs of praise. God bless you.
Good morning. We are going to be worshiping the Lord. Our first song is going to be a selection, My Life is in Your Hands. And I know that as you worship joyfully and you sing with all your strength, that the Lord will be there, because he said we'll be in the praises of his people. So we are going to praise him this morning, and as they give us the tune for that song.
And don't you be afraid.
come our way, we know that he is there. We give God the praise, we give him the glory. Our next selection is going to be God on the Mountain. You know, life is easy when you're on the mountain, but sometimes you are not on the mountain. So we thank God for the opportunity that he has given us to worship this morning, to call on him and praise his name. So our song is God on the Mountain. And we'll wait for the tune, and then you'll sing along with me and with us. We all sing together to praise the Lord. God on the Mountain.
When you're up on the mountain, you've got peace of mind like you've never known. But things change when you're down in the valley. Don't lose faith. You're never alone. For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, he'll make them right. And the God of the good times is when you're up on the mountain, talk comes so easy. When life's at its best, now it's down in the valley. Trials and temptations, that's where you're.
We thank God for that selection. Our next selection before prayer is going to be Great is Thy Faithfulness. Great is Thy Faithfulness, O God my Father. There is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not, Thy compassions they fail not. As Thou hast been, Thou forever will be. Summer and winter and spring, time and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all the nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Let's join together as they give us the tune to that song.
Thank you.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter, springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and a peace that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
Amen, amen, amen. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord, my Father. We thank God for this opportunity that he has given us. Let us bow our head in prayer as we go before the throne of grace to receive mercy in the hour of need. Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning. We give you praise, we give you glory. We thank you, O God, because we know that there is nothing impossible for you to do. There is no situation you are not aware of. Even in the midst of this pestilence, in the midst of this pandemic, you are in your power on your throne. Oh, Father, we thank you, we glorify you. We thank you for your keeping power. We thank you, God, for watching over us. We thank you, God, for covering us with the blood of Jesus. We thank you, God, for giving us the assurance, oh, that you will never leave us nor forsake us, whether we are on the mountain or in the valley. Oh, Father, you are there with us. Oh, Father, we thank you, we glorify you. We thank you for the opportunity that you have given us this morning. We give you all the praise, we give you all the glory. Oh, Father, we remember those who have lost loved ones, even in this situation, oh God. Oh, we pray that you comfort them, oh Lord. Oh, we pray that you strengthen them, oh God. Oh, Father, we pray, oh God, that the whole world will turn unto you, oh God. Oh, they will realize that there is no salvation in no other. There is no name given under heaven whereby we might be saved by the name Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, we thank you. We thank you for giving us your Son. You say you have given us all things in Jesus Christ. Oh, you have given us healing. You have given us deliverance. Oh, you have given us salvation. Oh, Father, you have given us everything that we need. Oh, Father, we give you praise. We give you glory. As we join together over the line, oh God, oh, looking unto you, calling on your name, you know the needs of your people, oh God. You know each and every circumstance, oh God. You know each and every home, oh Lord. Oh, Father, we are praying this morning. Oh, send your word and reach out, oh God. Touch each and every one at the sound of my voice, oh God. Oh, Father, touch each and every one that our loved ones we are looking unto you for, oh Lord. Oh, Father, we thank you. Oh, we glorify you. We magnify you. Blessed be your name, oh God. Glory be unto you. Oh, Heavenly Father, we are praying, oh God. Oh, we are praying for our leaders, oh God. Oh, Father, we are praying for the presidents. Oh, for the senators. Oh, for the Congress people. Oh, Father, we are praying, oh God, that you give them wisdom. Oh, Father, give them wisdom, oh Lord. Oh, give them understanding, oh God. Oh, Father, let them know, oh Lord, that you are the only one they can turn to. Oh, Father, help us, oh God, as a nation. Oh, help this world, oh Lord. Oh, that we will repent of our sins, oh God. Oh, we'll turn unto you, oh God. Oh, and you will heal the land. Oh, Father, we thank you, we glorify you. Blessed be your name, oh God. Glory be unto you. Oh, may your name be praised. Oh, that even at the end of this situation that we are in right now, oh God. Oh, when everything will have been concluded. Oh, we'll have cause to glorify you. We'll have cause to magnify you. Oh, the whole world will know, oh, that there is no other but you, oh God. Oh, Father, we thank you. Oh, we glorify you. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your goodness. Blessed be your name. Oh, Father, we look unto you, oh God. Oh, Father, bless your people, oh God. Oh, those who are sick, touch them, oh Lord. Oh, those who are bereaved, touch them, oh God. Oh, those who are in lack of one thing or the other, oh Father, provide, oh God. Oh Father, open gates, oh God. Open doors, oh God. Oh Father, we thank you, we glorify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen and amen. Our pastor will come before us with the announcements.
Amen. We thank God for that prayer. Amen. We know that in this time that we're living in, we adhere to the word of God that tells us that we can come boldly to the throne of grace and we can find mercy and grace to help in the time of need. So truly we are in a time of need and we come to a God that can only meet our need today. But we come with thanksgiving, amen, as the saints of God. Hallelujah. We are the light of the world. We are the salt of the earth. Glory be to God. So in the midst of this crisis, we are to give God praise. I just feel the joy of the Lord because the joy of the Lord is our strength. And in this time of need, we must be examples to a lost and dying world that our Savior is alive. Again, we welcome you to our live broadcast. We are broadcasting from the Apostolic Faith Church, located at 1325 Branch Avenue, Southeast Washington, D.C. In accordance with our government guidelines, four of us are gathered here in the sanctuary this morning. The assistant pastor, Brother Ayo Mobileri, and two of our media team. And we thank God for them. They have worked tirelessly in the last 48 hours to ensure that we have this live broadcast to our saints and all that are joining with us this morning. So we are so thankful for all that God is doing. We are, as the prayer went forth, we're remembering all that are affected by the coronavirus. I think we all are in one way or another. We're especially remembering those that are standing in need and are assisting those that are in hospitals and nursing homes, our doctors, our nurses, those that are labeled as essential. So it goes further than doctors and nurses. It's our police that protect us, and it's also our warehouse workers, those that work in the grocery store, that we are there trying to get food, but they are there serving us. Amen? Hallelujah. So we just thank God, and we pray that the blood of Jesus will cover us. In way of announcements, I do want to do a brief apology to our DC Saints if you were not aware of some of the schedule changes. But we want to make some adjustments now. Going forward, Lord willing, on tomorrow, our regular scheduled Monday night prayer will be online at 7:30 p.m., from 7:30 till 8:30 p.m. On Tuesday, we will go to our regular scheduled services. Tuesday service is scheduled for Reston, our Reston Fellowship, and our Baltimore group. They have an online prayer at 7:30 p.m. Please see Brother Oladary for numbers for that. Also on Wednesday, the Women Fellowship will continue with their regular scheduled prayer line at 9 o'clock p.m. Amen? On Thursday, the Men's Fellowship prayer line is scheduled at 8 o'clock p.m. And Friday, Bible study is online at 7:30 p.m. As you see, the D.C. Church, we were having services. This is our regular schedule before the corona crisis. We want to alert our saints that the 7:30 prayer line for the church number will not be effective the whole week. Amen? Due to the overflow of people that are using the internet and conference lines, our carrier has suggested that people stagger their group sessions. So that's why we are going back to our regular schedule. So it doesn't mean that we'll stop praying. We are always praying, but we will be praying in our groups as we have been doing all along. Amen? So we give God thanks and we give him praise. Truly, as the songs have gone forth, God is faithful. Truly, I can say this morning that I found no failure in him. I found him to be everything that his word said that he would be. And truly, God is real, God is faithful, and he is the one that will see us through and take us through. So let us continue to worship him. We have a lot of songs that we sung this morning because we wanted you to feel connected. I didn't see when I looked at the list of essential people, I may missed it, but I didn't see the clergy, but I felt like that we were essential, amen, because we're essential for the encouragement of the saints of God. So that's why myself and the assistant pastor is here this morning to come before you to encourage you and to encourage ourselves in the word of God. At this time, we will have a selection. Brother Ayo will come back before us. God bless you. Thank you so much.
Well, thank God that we are continuing in this service. We'll have a selection. The words will be displayed on the screen for you, and also the music. We'll start and we'll go with that selection. That'll be a song of praise instead of the testimony service. And after this selection, there'll be a scripture reading. After the scripture reading, there'll be a special selection that'll be sung by me. And after that, we'll have the message. And following that, we'll have the altar call and benediction. So we'll have the selection displayed on the screen for you to follow, and the tune will be given.
Oh, hallelujah.
God for that selection. Next is our scripture reading, and we'll be going to Psalm 46, verses 1 through 11. Our scripture reading this morning will be coming from Psalm 46. Psalm 46, verse 1. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heathen raged. The kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord, what desolation he had made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Amen. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. And we'll have a special song. And that special song will be "All to Jesus I Surrender." All to Jesus I surrender. All to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence daily live. I surrender all. I surrender all. All to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. All to Jesus I surrender. Humbly I thy feet I bow. Worldly pleasures all forsaken, take me, Jesus, take me now. I surrender all. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. All to Jesus I surrender. Lord, I give myself to thee. Fill me with thy love and power. Let thy blessings fall on me. I surrender all. I surrender all. All to thee, my I surrender all. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. I surrender all. All to Jesus, I surrender. May the Lord help us in times like these to surrender all to Jesus. We're going to look briefly at our scripture that was read, Psalms 46, and we're focusing on verse 10. A very familiar scripture, and I'm sure that we have been hearing this from the last couple weeks over and over. But every time I hear or receive the word of God, it speaks afresh. The word of God should always have fresh meaning to us, and we pray that it will to us again this morning. Verse 10 say, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. When we need consolation, we go to the Word of God. And the Word of God will encourage us, as it is this morning. This psalm was written after Hezekiah had prayed and sought God, and God had sent 180, that God had killed 180,000 Assyrians with one angel. God will show himself mighty in the midst of his people. Let them know that I can take one angel and do more than your great army. So it helped us to focus on where our trust should be this morning. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. This morning, some may consider that the world is in trouble. But I believe that God is still in control. Hallelujah. Amen. Because he said, therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. This psalm is written to God's people. As God's people, we know in whom we believe. Glory be to God. Amen. And where our trust lies. As I was meditating on verse 10, here God is speaking in the first person, saying, be still and know that I am God. What does it really mean to be still? To be physically stop moving, to be emotionally settled. Why did God have to say, you need to be still? Sometimes we're moving so fast that we cannot reflect that God is God. We have forgotten about God's deliverance on yesterday when today's circumstances is before us. But he said, in order to really see who God is, we have to be still. To be still means that you have to stop fighting your own battle. You have to realize that the battle is not ours, it is the Lord's. And that's why all over the world, prayer is pointed to our true and living God. To be still in this day and time is not easy. Even though we may physically be stationary in one place, that does not mean that we are being still. In this time of technology, I have a 13-year-old grandson, And it's amazing how many things that he can be doing at one time. I looked at him, and he was sitting at his workstation. He had his TV up before him on a monitor. He had his laptop on the desk. And then beside the laptop, he had his cell phone. And they all was on. I said, well, what are you doing? Are you looking at the TV? I'm looking at the TV. I'm playing a game on my laptop. And I'm also chatting or communicating something on my cell phone. In order to be still, something has to be turned off. God wants us to come to a place that we can know that I am God. I realize that there are different levels of knowing. Sometimes we can know a level of intellectual knowing. We can know a level of our being influenced by someone else. But God say, I need you to know and know that you know that I am God. Because when we know this, there is a peace. There is a peace that comes in our spirit. And God is so faithful. When we desire to know him, he will take time and reveal himself. In St. John, the third chapter, a very familiar encounter here, it says that there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. For no man can do these miracles that thou doest except God be with him. Here we see that Nicodemus must have heard about Jesus. And he wanted to know more about him. He came to Jesus by night. Jesus did not dismiss him because he came by night. We can come to Jesus now that we, a lot of us, are not able to be in a physical church, but wherever you are, you can come to Jesus. Nicodemus came by night, and he said unto him, he addressed him as Rabbi. And he let him know what he already knew. He said, I know that thou art a teacher. I've heard you. Being a Pharisee, he was well knowledgeable in the scripture. Not only just a Pharisee, but a ruler. So he may have stood afar off and he heard Jesus. And he knew that thou art a teacher. And not only are you a teacher, but you come from God. You're greater than I am. You come from God. Why? Because I have observed something. No man can do these miracles that thou doeth except God be with him. Glory be to God. Amen. Nicodemus had a level of knowing that led him to come to Jesus, to question him. Sometimes we may have a certain level of knowing. And this morning, if you really want to have an encounter with Jesus, the Spirit of the living God is here to draw us. Amen. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. This ruler of the Jews still went further in questioning. You know, sometimes we have questions, but we're looking for the answer that we want to hear. And if we don't hear what we want to hear, we might dismiss it. But Nicodemus came with the right spirit. He really wanted to know. And Jesus answered him, knowing that it would take the Spirit of God to reveal it unto Nicodemus. The Word of God tells us that Jesus answered and said unto him, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Of course, Nicodemus, thinking in the natural, wanted to know, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? This was a legitimate natural question. But just that he asked the question, let us know that he was sincere. When we are sincere, God will meet us where we are. Wherever you may be, God will meet us there. Glory be to God. The question may seem something that maybe, oh, that's trivial. But Jesus will take time to answer. He said, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. Because Nicodemus took time to ask that question, it's recorded in the scripture, and men and women through the ages have come to Christ because this man asked the question that was in their spirit. And Jesus answered. He went on to open things up. But here the Word of God did not give us the revelation that Nicodemus immediately repented and accepted. But as we look further into the scripture, we see that at the crucifixion, Nicodemus was there. So it let us know that this conversation that he had with Jesus, it did bear fruit in his life, that he came to a place of repentance. So we need to know that he is God. He said, be still. That's almost like, and it is a command when he say, be still. Lots of times we are in situations, and because we have been trained by our society to try to rectify it ourselves, to bring it to a conclusion and work it out ourselves. But God will allow sometimes things to happen that only he can fix. And in the midst of that, he tells his people to be still. Even though we know that God is in control, sometimes that does not dismiss us from sometimes being anxious. A couple weeks ago, when I was traveling back from Atlanta to D.C., after coming through the checkpoint there at the airport, I went on and got something to eat. And later on, I found out that I had misplaced or did not have a very important document. But God is faithful. In the midst of that, God gave me an unusual peace. a piece that it was really, I knew it was the Spirit of God. But I still did my due diligence looking for it. And I looked, and I could not find it. And later on, I just went to the restroom, and I just said, Lord, you know where it is. I don't know. In other words, you have the answer. I do not know, but I know you know where it is. I came out, and I opened up my bag, and I looked where I had already looked two or three times, and there it was. And the Lord let me know that we can trust him. He just wants us to cry out to him. Stop our efforts to try to fix it. Hallelujah. Amen. Whatever, not just this virus, but our situations that in our lives and in our relationships and in our marriages and with our children and with our employment. Be still. And once I got still, God showed it to me. And I cannot really understand how I know I had looked there at that same point. But because I was maybe too anxious, I didn't see it. We can miss God if we are anxious. We can miss God if there is fear. That's why he comes back with the word of God to encourage us that I am your refuge and your strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, will not we fear. We will continue to look to the hills from which cometh our help. All of our help cometh from the Lord. When God is getting ready to move, we have to be still. At the Red Sea, he told Moses, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. The children of Israel were murmuring, you have brought us out into this desert. And now Pharaoh is behind us. But God spoke and said, be still and see the salvation of the Lord. I believe that if we be still, we will see the salvation of the Lord. God has not forsaken his people. God is with us. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm thoroughly encouraged this morning. God has given me a peace in my spirit. Hallelujah. Not that I'm not concerned and not that I'm not doing due diligence. But I know in whom I believe. I told someone the other day that we are going to have to stand on the word that we have been preaching, that we have been teaching. In the midst of trial, we have to know that God is still God. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. Though the heathen rage, the kingdoms remove, he uttered his voice and the earth melted. But the Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. During this time, we can give testimony and we can give witness to a lost and dying world that this gospel is real, that this God is well able to do more than we can even ask or think, that he is our protector, that he is our keeper. We can be a witness not only as we go out, but even in our homes. Hallelujah. Amen. I thank God for my son. He is an essential worker because he works in a delivery company, a national delivery. And His work is essential. And I said, well, when we think about essential, mostly we're hearing it's about the medical profession. But he said, Mother, in order for the medical profession to get the supplies, the trucks got to bring it to the warehouse, and we have to unload it. Hallelujah. Amen. So that's why we must continue to pray that everyone be covered. But he was going out getting all these things and just filling up the house. And I told him, don't bring anything else in here. Hallelujah. We are fine. God will see us through. Amen. Glory be to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We can be witnesses by our action. We should not be in the store pulling everything off the shelves. As saints of God, we should have a peace about us. Glory be to God. Amen. As I was in the store the other day, and a lady that was behind me, she looked at my cart and she saw it was almost empty because I only got what I came to get. And she offered me money to purchase this item for her, because she was only allowed to get one and she needed two. So she was going to pay me for the item and additional money just to get it. Glory be to God. In those instances, we must know in whom we believe. Amen. We can be a witness. Amen. That our God. Amen. Is a refuge. Amen. And a strength in the time of need. We can know him. If you want to know him today, you may be like Nicodemus. You may not want to come in a crowd. So here this morning in the DC sanctuary, it's just four of us. But wherever you are, glory be to God, you can cry out to him. If you have a question, don't think that God will dismiss you. He did not dismiss Nicodemus. He did not say that, Nicodemus, you are a ruler. You are well learned. You should know better. Glory be to God. But God is faithful. He's not willing that any should perish, but that we all should come to repentance and the knowledge of our Lord and Savior. I'll close with a very familiar scripture, John 3:16. For God so loved the world. Glory be to God. Amen. The world need to know this morning that God loves them. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. He loved us so much that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. This morning you can know him. Let us be still. Let us meditate on the goodness of God. Let's not forget that the same God that delivered yesterday is still delivering today. The same God that healed on yesterday is still healing today. Hallelujah. Amen. The same God that brought us through crisis and disappointments is here to console us. Amen. Many hearts are broken. Amen. And we are aware, and we have compassion, and we reach out and we pray, glory be to God, that the God of all comfort will comfort. Hallelujah. That he will speak. He will give you, just like he did to Nicodemus. He answered his question, and then he went on and started teaching about something else. Because after he had given him the answer, it was up to Nicodemus to make the decision. But I'm so glad that the Word of God let us know that Nicodemus, somewhere along the line, made the decision. Hallelujah. This morning, will you make the decision to follow Jesus? Will we take time to be still in our spirit? Be still in all the information that we are hearing. And we need that information, but we need this information. We need the Word of God. We need to look into the Word of God to be reminded that He is our refuge. He is our strength. He is our deliverer. He's mighty to save. He's mighty to keep. His love is everlasting, and His mercy endureth forever. God bless you.
We thank God that you have been able to join us this morning. Wherever you are, make that an altar to come to God and look unto Him, just like Nicodemus came to Jesus Christ, as we have had, and look unto Him, and Lord will answer our prayers. We'll close with the song, "My Life is in Your Hands." It says you don't have to be worried. You don't have to be afraid. Be still and know that the Lord is God. So we'll give a tune of that song. And while the song is praying, I will just say a short prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. We thank you for the word that we have heard, that we can come unto you, oh, and you will not reject any. Oh, Father, this morning we are coming to you, oh Lord. We want to put our lives in your hand. We want to be still. Oh, Father, we want to look unto you. We want to commit everything into your hands. Oh, Father, we don't want to be anxious. Oh, we don't want to have a double mind, but we want to trust in you. Father, we thank you. We glorify you. Oh, Father, meet your people wherever they may be this morning. Heavenly Father, let your peace reign in our hearts. Oh, Father, let your love flow over us, oh Lord. And Heavenly Father, and if there are any, oh, who have not committed unto you, O Lord, Father, help them, O God, to come to you this morning. Oh, and to leave everything in your hands. And we know that you will bless. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.